What's up, good people? How you doing today? Welcome to Stock Up with Larry Jones. For those of you that's new to the page, go ahead, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell. Those of you that's been rolling with me for a while, just go ahead and hit the like button. Today, we're going to talk about the stock market overall, stock that I think that are going to do well, and what I think is going to happen in the next week or two with the stock market, okay? All right, let's get it pumping. As you can see, I'm not in my normal studio. I had a mishap. My mood light, I was moving it and it exploded. It just hit the floor and exploded. It's full of liquid. So just cleaning that up. So today I'm in Studio B. All right. So first of all, below I have a link for Webull. And Webull, I have a partnership with Webull. And you download the app. There's a link below. If you click the link, download the app, deposit $100, you get two free stock up to $50 for your $100. And what I really like about Webull is, of course, depending on where you live, you could start trading from 4 a.m. to 8 p.m., all right? So pre-market and post-market, and you have the charts in real time, okay? So that's a great tool. I also want to say, if you see any correspondent, not just for me, but for anybody, and it's talking about a WhatsApp, a phone number, or talk to my broker, it's spam, good people. I'm trying to protect you guys. I've been just saying this over and over. Okay, let's get right to it. All right, shall we? All right, so I got some notes right here. I'm out of my element for those of you that's been rolling with the family. Okay, so I believe we've tested the bottom on Friday. I really believe we tested the bottom on Friday, meaning Friday's low could have been the bottom. I believe it was. And then it rebounds. So what happens in a correction, which we're in, is the last of the fearful sell off. And it just bottoms out. And the reason why it comes back is the buyers have been waiting for the sellers to bottom out. And then everybody buys back in. That's showing where the bottom is. And then there's other key indicators, but I'm just telling you what happens during this. I was one of those buyers. For those of you that know, you know, I bought a share of Tesla, and I've been doing a dollar cost average in. All right, because it's the safest way to make money during a correction, because no one knows where the bottom is. Having said that, I think that we've tested the bottom Friday at its lows. So what we need to do is look at stock you want to get into, or stock that you have that have tanked. Look at where the bottoms were Friday. If it retests that this coming week, you know you're in at a good buy. Now, it literally could go lower than that. Now, I'm just telling you what Larry thinks. Remember, before you make any financial decisions, you must first do your own due diligence, do your own research, okay? And then consult with your financial advisor, to which I am not. I'm just Larry telling you what I'm doing, all right? So I'm looking for stock that has got hit the hardest, right? So Kathy Woods mentioned that EVs and future tech companies, that companies that are emerging markets, I always talk about, that are the future, fintech, biotech, those type of companies, charging stations. She believes, and I do too. I'm going to sign off and say I believe it too. Those got hit the hardest. Of course, tech got hit the hardest, right? And it got hit multiple times. But it's also, I believe, in the next 3 to 5 years, are going to have the greatest gains, right? High risk, high reward. So I'm putting my money into those areas. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm putting my money into those areas because you should be investing as well as trading. This is not Vegas. We're building financial wealth here, good people. We're building generational wealth. So don't be in a rush, just like you shouldn't have been in a rush to panic sell, because it showed you Friday, I believe, showed you where the dip is. Now, this coming week, like I've been stating, I believe we're still in a correction. And I believe that this week, I'm actually excited for this week, because one of two things. Monday could show a sign, which is tomorrow, could show a sign that we're out. Friday could have been the bottom. No one has a crystal ball. But I'm going to tread lightly. I'm going to go in easy, and I'm going to dollar cost average in, because Friday could have just tested the bottom. And believe it or not, if the bottom hits again, if sometime this coming week, say Wednesday, it dips again like it did, that's when I'm going to have limit orders to buy big, because it's showing you where the bottom is. Okay. So that's what we have to look at. So now we got to look at stock that are going to be, that you think that were oversold and undervalued. Kathy Woods think that EVs will have an annual return of 82%. That's crazy. Over the next 3 to 5 years. That's like crazy gains. And I sort of agree with her. I really do. I really do. And so I'm going to put my money where my mouth is. You know, I'm looking at companies like NIO, N-I-O. If it does not come off of the bottom, if it doesn't shoot up Monday morning, I'm going to buy some more NIO. I got enough of NNDM, but for those of you that don't have any, I could tell you that if it hits where the bottoms are, where it was Friday, I would buy. Just take a look. I want you to do your own due diligence and see where it was Friday at the low. And I would say, tell you that's a buy. Tesla, same deal. At the low, I would tell you that's a buy. Palantir, PLTR, I would also tell you that Friday's dips, that's where the buy is. And with the exception of NIO, I bought all of these close to that dip. So when it dipped, I'm like, this, it can't keep going down. And it got so far down. Remember, you got to be brave when others are scared, and you got to be scared when others are brave. Meaning you should be selling when others are buying, and you should be buying when others are selling. So let me tell you this. Here's what happened. A lot of you guys are new to the stock market, meaning less than a year, right? A lot of you, tell the truth, raise your hand if this is you. A lot of you got into the stock market because you heard it was running, right? So you got in. So here's a stock market. It's a wave like this. I should draw one. So it goes down, it comes up, it goes down, it comes up. So a lot of you bought it right here because this is when the rumor got out. Hey, you should put your money in the stock market. It's running, right? And so you bought it here, and then it ran up a little bit more. You were happy, right? So this starts tanking, correcting, and then you get fearful down here and sell. But the smart people are buying down here and selling up here. So what it takes courage. And when you, wherever you buy and you in a good, solid company, you know what else it takes? Courage and faith, actually. It takes faith. It takes a lot of faith to hold on to a stock that's tanking every day. It takes courage to even buy more of that stock, to double down on that stock. And so that's why I'm brave when others are fearful, right? And it has worked for me for over 25 years. And I had to learn the hard way. My first 5 years, I made every dumb mistake I could make. I had FOMO, so I chased stock up. I panic sold. Oh, it's dropping. And I kept selling at a loss. And everything I did was polar opposite of what you should do. And so that's why I always tell you guys, you think it's a small thing, but it's a big thing. Write the vision, make it plain. I have my disciplines written down. And when the stock market is falling, I literally look at my disciplines and I say, oh my goodness, the stock market has failed so much. Let me see what my disciplines say. It says, when the stock market falls, treat it like you're a new investor. Meaning, I treat it like I just got in. So if you just got in Friday, think about this, good people. If you just got in Friday at the bottom, you hit jackpot. If you bought some NIO, some NNDM, Tesla, Palantir, a lot of these other great stock at the bottom, just think about that. If those of you that have gotten in, those of you that made great gains in the bull market of 2020, think about all the cash, all the liquidity that you put in. Just think, if you've never bought a stock and you just bought it at Friday's dip, you would be doing good. This is really a good lesson, this correction. And a correction is actually healthy for the economy. So we got a lot of good things coming, right? We got, you know, the stimulus thing, which I think is just one component. And yes, the market has absorbed a lot of the information. The market is getting smarter and smarter and smarter, like COVID. It starts, okay, you're figuring me out, so I'm going to start mutating. And so that's what the market starts doing. You know, it's literally going, so, okay, yeah, you got the stimulus check coming in. That's good. I already priced that in to where I'm at right now. But there's other good things because we're behind in COVID shots. And I can tell you right now, in a month's time, by April, by the end of April, we're going to be actually by the end of March, we're going to be ahead. I believe, especially by the end of April. So we're going to go from behind, going behind the shot and how many people have gotten the vaccine shots to ahead. So that means lower numbers, right? So we're going to be reporting lower numbers, lower numbers, lower numbers, if y'all don't go crazy out there. And so that's good for the stock market. Then the stimulus checks, they're talking about by the end of the month. Most people will have it by the beginning of next month. All this new money. Literally, we're going to go, I think, because of the pent-up demand, we're going to go into the roaring 20s again. People are itching to spend money. People are itching to get on a plane, a boat. I would be looking at the post-COVID stock like never before. And what's going to happen is that money that's burning a hole in a lot of people's pocket and including the extra money that's coming from the stimulus, that money's got to be spent, right? And when it gets spent, it's going to go into the economy and that's going to be good, right? And so I'm going to say something else that's really bold. If we're going to test the bottom again, I hope it happens Monday. I hope it happens immediately because that could be the best thing for us. So we know where the bottom is if it tests again. For me, I'm going to have some buy limit orders in. I'm going to put them in tonight because if it hits, not tonight, Monday afternoon, I remember that first 2 hours of trading on Monday morning is tricky, good people. I rarely buy stock then because a lot of stock have that morning pop and then it comes down. So I wait till about 11:30, okay? That's what Larry do. And so then I'm going to set my limit buy-ins on these companies, especially NIO, because that's where I see an opportunity that I have not yet taken advantage of. Okay. But I am not going all in Monday. Good people. I'm still going to dollar cost average in this week. Patience is a virtue. Good people. It's Sunday. I'm sounding like Joel Osteen. This is my portfolio. I am what it says I am. Good people. We're going to make money. I got joy today because I know that short, long term, I'm going to make good money. More. What makes me even more happy is I'm going to help you guys make more money. For those of you that has had diamond hands and that have held on through this bloodbath, I'm telling you right now, your day is coming. Brighter days are coming. And it's really days away if you really think about it. And you're going to say, I held out even against my gut. I held out and look at the payoff. So this is what I want you to do. Take a snapshot of your portfolio today. And at the end of March, look at it. And that's how you learn the lesson that it took me 5 years to learn. You'll learn it right away. Hey, I'm going to leave it right there again. Do me a favor. Like this video if you've been rolling with me. If you have not subscribed, subscribe. And most importantly, good people, if you subscribed, hit that notification bell and make sure it's checked for all. A lot of you guys haven't hit it. My analytics are showing me that, okay? There again, below I have a link for Webull and Coinbase if you want to get into some crypto. But make sure you download that Webull app. And I'll tell you right now, Webull has really helped me through this, because being able to see what's happened post-market, before the market opened, and seeing what's happening after the market closed will make you more money. All right? All right. Hey, we love you good people. Hopefully I'll be back into my regular digs and my regular studio. Live, love, laugh, and learn.